Everlasting Father, King of glory, we just bless and worship you. The I am that I am, we thank you for your strength, your ever help in time of need. Lord, we honor your name. We thank you, Lord, for this is a day which you have made, in which we will rejoice and be glad indeed. We thank you, Lord, for your name is the name that is above every name. It is not just a name, it is the name that is above every name. For the word of God says, in the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus is Lord. Father, we confess your Lordship this morning. We confess that you are our strength, you are shelter, you are our shield. Father, we just honor you because in you there is peace, in you there is joy. Because you know that the whole purpose of our existence is to serve you, to worship you, to exalt you, to make you first and foremost in our lives. So Lord, we just thank you. We thank you, Lord, for this is a day that we will rejoice and give you the glory. Father, as we look at your word this morning, let your word direct. Let your word lead us. Let your word be light unto our footpath, Lord, so that we will not fall by the wayside. Your word says many are called, but few will be chosen. Lord, out of those few that will be chosen, Lord, we just pray that the listeners of this message this morning will be counted among them, Lord. That I will be counted among them. Apostle Paul says, I do not count myself to have reached, but I keep pressing towards the mark. Lord, give us the grace, Lord, just as Apostle Paul says, that we'll be able to keep pressing, that we do not have a complacent attitude that we have reached. Because the word says, anybody who thinks that he stand, take heed lest he fall. Because this is the end time. The whole love of many shall wax cold, and it shall be lovers of money rather than lovers of men. Rather than lovers of what is good, rather than lovers of what is precious. So Lord, energize us. Lord, wake us up from our slumber, because there is a way that seemeth right unto man. The end thereof is destruction. Lord, open our spiritual eyes of understanding so that we walk in that path, Lord. Father, I thank you, Lord, for your revelation. The listener that is saying, yes, I know that it is tough, it is rough. So Lord, I just speak your word of smoothness, your word that will enlighten that individual that is listening to me this morning in Jesus' name. Everlasting Father, there are millions of people that wake up and they don't even think of how they are going to have a daily meal. Everlasting Father, we just pray, Lord, that you that provided manna from above for the children of Israel, Lord, provide for them in Jesus' name. Provide in a miraculous way so that they do not put their trust in man. The arm of flesh will fail, but you are the only one that never fails. You are the only one that is forever ascertained. Lord, I just commit that individual. Yes, the home is so troubled. Yes, the home, your family is so troubled that you just keep fighting. You say, are we going to survive this troublesome family? I want to speak the word of God into you. That yes, the Lord says that I am with you. The Lord says that he's not going to leave you alone in that troubled family, and only remain steadfast. Stay there. Do not yield to the right or to the left. Just stay in the middle. Just stay focused on the Lord. Yes, I know your son is giving you that terrible, terrible, terrible problem. That you say, well, how? What am I going to do? Is into drugs? So Lord, I just pray for that individual, Lord. I just pray for that son that is in drug problem, Lord. Everlasting Father, just deliver. Lord, set free. Because there is nothing that is impossible with you. Because your word says, all men have sinned and come short of the glory of God. So set deliverance. Set deliverance. Yes, you are listening to me. You say, well, this problem is so overwhelming. I don't believe. Just like the disciples, they were praying for Peter to be released. Rhoda went and just hugged voice of Peter knocking at the door. The disciples did not believe, but Lord, unbelief. I just prayed, Lord, for you, that woman. Yes, he said, I have prayed, but the Lord God of Abraham is going to minister to the life of your son. Everlasting Father, we thank you, Lord. Because, yes, you are talking to me. Lord, you have a choice to make. Two options. You don't know what to do. Lord, I just pray that you lead such individual that is listening now, that Lord will be able to make the right choice, make the right decision. Because guidance is only from you. You are the only one that can lead. Not any minister, not any GOs, not any pastor. It's only the Spirit of the Lord that can lead. Because it's only the Spirit of the Lord that answers prayer. Eli did not read, could not read the mind of Hannah, but Hannah was able to commune with the Lord. And because she was able to commune with the Lord answers. The Lord that answereth by fire, let him be God. Yes, you are looking for a child of the womb. It looks everything is hopeless. You say, what am I going to do? But Hannah did not give up. Don't give up. The Lord is going to do it. Look at Sarah in her old age. God provided a child for Sarah. So Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the promises of God that is here and amen. Thank you, Lord, because when you reveal your word, you make it come to pass. And as you look at your word this morning, because the name of Jesus is a strong, is the name of the Lord is a strong tower. Jesus is Lord, and the name of Jesus is a strong tower. As you look at that new name, the name that you have given unto those whose faith is established upon you, Lord, just minister to us and let your name be glorified. Father, we honor you, we give you the glory, for we have prayed in Jesus' name. I welcome all of you this morning. And it's such a cool day in Regina, Saskatchewan. The current temperature is minus 27. I don't think with moon chill. Whatever it is, our houses, they are warm. You are not standing on the roadside, but it is cold. So the Lord gave us a message this morning. It was a message that titled, He Has Been Given a New Name. We're going to look at what is in the name. I'm going to look at it from the Oxford Dictionary first. When you look at the word name, name is a noun, a word or set of words by which a person, animal, place, or thing is known, addressed, or referred to. Names are assigned to objects also. We talk of spoon, we talk of cup, we talk of tables, we talk of so many things. But we are going to look at name from a selected perspective this morning. Traditionally, in many cultures, especially in Africa where I come from, names are so important and they have meanings. When you look at somebody, when you have it, when you are pregnant, you are looking for what name do I want to give to this child. You realize that traditionally they have so many gods, just like in India, all over the world where we have so many gods, small g. They go and consult the oracles. They consult Ifa. They consult Obatala. They consult Shango. These are all different gods. And when you see some of these gods, they are worshipped, some of them, in South America, in Brazil, because some of them are descendants of Africans that they are taken there as slaves and they grew up there. And some of them, before they give any name to a child, they go and consult the oracles. At times, they look at the circumstances that surround the birth of that child. They look at, oh, was he born after the oldest member of the family died? And what happens is that they give the name of that individual who passed away. At times they say, oh, this child looks like my great-grandfather. And what happens? They call him the name of the grandfather. There are so many circumstances that we look into. But when we look at some people, either in the Western world, but it's very common in the Western world, or even developing or underdeveloped countries, they just name it, oh, I like that actress. Oh, I like that, I watch that movie, the name of that, this thing, that's what I'm going to call my son. Or some people, they just wake up, they just call that name. They just say the name that doesn't mean anything. And I want you to know that names is very important. And that is what we are going to look at this morning. When you come from a notable family, what happens is that people don't want you to spoil the name. They say, oh, we have a name in our family. What he's saying is that don't spoil that name. When you look at some names in history, we talk of Prophet Joseph Ayobabalola, the founder of the Christ Apostolic Church worldwide. Once you mention Joseph, Pastor Joseph Ayobabalola, or you mention Babalola, people say, are you related to the prophet? You see, when you look at that prophet, he was anointed by God, called by the Almighty, and he did such a mighty work in Africa, and he traveled all over the world. There was a man whom God used mightily. And when you look at kings and rulers, there was the story of Obad T.B. Akinyele, one time Olubadan of Ibadan. He was the king of one of the big cities in Nigeria, if the second or third cities, biggest city in Nigeria. He was a king, and as a king, they had to do all the rituals, they had to do everything. But this man of God, this prophet of God, said, no, I will not get myself engaged in your rituals, your traditional rituals. And what happened? He decided to follow the word of God, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God that never fails. And they tried him with all the occultic work, but he did not prevail. We don't have time to look into that. History had it that he made Christ the God of the time. And when you look at some who are not even Christians, we talk of Are Musulumi of Yoruba land in Nigeria. We talk of Emperor. We talk of so many people. And we talk of Alhaji Arisekola. He passed away a few years ago. What happened was that the name became so popular. Some names are known for certain things. This man, though a Muslim, was very generous in everything that he did. And when you look at the name, your name is very important, because when you are born, you are given a name. Some of us have names that we do not like. Some will change their names when they grow up and find the meaning of the name. I know of some people whose names and name are given after idol worshippers. And when some individuals grow up, what do? They change that name. That is why this morning you need to be given a new name. Because Jesus is the name. Jesus Christ is the name that is above every name. The moment you are born again, the moment you accept Christ as your Lord and Savior, you are given a new name. Name is so important, because it is through name, when we go to the Father, when we go to Him, we call upon Him, we say, Lord, I need your grace. In the name of what? Not in the name of your parents, but in the name of Jesus. Because the name of Jesus is the name that is above every name. We are going to look at the latter aspect that I just mentioned. Some of us have names that you do not like. I used to make a joke to some of my friends and say, I don't know why my father decided to call me Amos. He could have called me Moses. Because at times I have to spell Amos, especially those who are not reading the word of God. Those who don't know the minor prophets, they don't know the prophets in the scriptures. I say A-M-O-S. Oh, some will say Moses. I say no. Even after I've spelled it, they say that it is Moses, M-O-S-E-S. Because when you look at the Moses, the deliverer of the children of Israel, What a great name. And we are going to look a name. We look at names of countries. When we talk of America, people don't even forget that we have North America, we have South America. They just think you are talking of USA. They don't think about Canada. They don't think about Brazil. Because America has a name. And the Lord says he has been given a name that is above every name. And the name of Jesus is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are saved. We are going to look from the scriptures now. We've talked about all these different names. Let's look at it from the Word of God. Genesis chapter 17. It says, when Abraham was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to him and said, I am God Almighty. Walk before me faithfully and be blameless. I want to tell you that God wants you to walk faithfully. The Lord God that we serve wants you to walk blameless before him. He says, then I will make my covenant between me and you, and will greatly increase your number. You see, the secret of your prosperity, the secret of increasing in number is, in the first place, you walk before God faithfully and be blameless. You say, oh, do you mean I can be blameless? Yes, you can be blameless. You know when you can be blameless? When you accept Christ as your Lord and Savior and you live by grace. Because by grace you are saved. We are not talking of works. We are not saying that you are not going to make mistakes. I make mistakes every day. I make mistakes. My wife makes mistakes. My children make mistakes. We are not perfect. But when you walk by grace, God does not see your fault anymore. You are blameless before him. Abraham fell face down and God said to him, as for me, this is my covenant with you. You will be the father of many nations. No longer will you be called Abraham. Your name will be Abraham. You see, Abraham has been given what? A new name. I know there is no other name greater than the name of Jesus, because the name of the Lord is the strong tower. I give you testimonies about name, the name of Jesus that we have used in various difficult situations. I remember one year, that was the second year after I accepted Christ as my Lord and Savior. I went to see my parents at Oyo, and my dad woke me up early in the morning. He said, yes, I know you believe in this Jesus, and I believe in it. But my father goes into a occultic world and everything. And he said, there are some people that are after us in the family that will be having bad dreams. I said, bad dreams? Okay, but what about you? I said, no, I'm not having bad dreams. And he said, I know how to counter it. I said, how do we counter it? He said, he already got a hen for a sacrifice. And all my siblings, they are going to have 201 sacrifices. They use a knife or they use a blade, and very sharp blade, to make it from the forehead to the back. And you can be sure they'll be bleeding, and then they use some concoction to cover it so that no evil will overpower them. And I told him, I said, why not let's call this name Jesus and let us see, try him. Then he said, okay, if you want to try. The first night I prayed in the name of Jesus, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the I am that I am. Everybody went to bed, no bad dream. The second day, there was no bad dream. The third day, my father said, yes, the hen that I have prepared to be sacrificed, we are going to kill it and eat it, because the Lord intervened. I want you to know the name of Jesus is the name that is above every name. The name of Jesus is the name that is above every name. The name that is unique. How can a child be called that name over 2,000 years ago, Jesus Christ, and that name is still ringing? That name is still the most popular name, that once you mention the name of Jesus, everybody knows. So what happened to Abraham? God said to Abraham in verse 9, as for you, you must keep my covenant.
you and your descendants. So God said to Abraham, as for Sarai, your wife, you are no longer to call her Sarah. It's spelled S-A-R-A-I. Her name will be Sarah. I will bless her, and I will surely give you a son by her. I want you to know that there's so much importance attached to a name. When your name changes, your name is going to change today as you listen to me. Your name is going to change because the moment you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, when that day in September 1973, when I accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior, the Lord has given me a new name. And the Lord is going to give you a new name this morning. You will not go back the same way you came. The same way you listen to this message, you'll be translated. So God said, but your wife will bear you a son, and you will call him Isaac. You see, every time there's a name change, there's always a promise. Jesus Christ says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. He says, nobody comes to the Father except by me. When you look at all this, the Lord says, I am. I am the I am that I am. He has given us all what we need, all what we need in him. And when we follow him, when we know him, when we follow his path, when we say, Lord, I want to do your will and your purpose, he fulfills all our desires. We look at Jacob wrestling with God. The same night he arose, that's in the book of Genesis, he took his two wives and he took them and sent them across the stream. And when the man saw that he did not prevail against Jacob, he touched his hip socket, and Jacob's hip was put out of joint. Then he said, let me go. And what happened? But Jacob said, I will not let you go unless you bless me. When you come to that state in your Christian life, when you say, Lord, despite the difficulty that I'm having, despite all the problems, I will not let you go. God comes to your instance. I was talking to a brother in Windsor, Ontario yesterday. He was telling me about the testimony of a minister who had a lot of problem with his son. The problem was sickness. They prayed for this son to be healed. No, it's sickness upon sickness. And this pastor, this man of God, came to a halt. He said, Lord, I did not ask of this son from any idol. I asked from you, and you gave this son to me. If you want to take this son, that is your own will to take. I'm not going to pray anymore. Behold, that was the last day that son ever fell ill. Because God that he serves is a God that establishes, is a God that knows you and has given you a name. And what happened? Let's look at verse 28. He said, your name shall no longer be called Jacob, but Israel, because you are striving with God, with men, and have prevailed. When God gives you a new name, the name of Jesus is a strong power. The name of the Lord, because are equivalent of Jesus is Lord, because he's God incarnate. And he says, this day the people of Israel do not eat. That's verse 32. They are forbidden from eating that part that was related to Jacob's hip. Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and has called his name Emmanuel. I want you to name the meaning of name. Name is so important. The child was given a name even before the delivery. For us, a child is born. To us, a son is given. That's in the book of Isaiah, chapter 9, verse 6. And the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. When you look at those names, in many traditions, just like in African tradition where I come from, when we give names, they can give up to 6 or 8 names. You will give names as a father. Your wife may have a name, your grandparents and your great-grandparents, and you just add everything together. And those names, they have meaning. And there is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. And this is where we are going this morning. There are so many of you that deceive yourself. You say, well, even in ancient countries, in the time of Abraham and Isaac, they had their gods. Yes, they had their gods. They still have gods. But what happens is that when you look at kings like Asa, when you look at kings like Manasseh, when you look at kings in those days, what did they do? They destroyed the temple of those gods. What is the temple of gods that you need to destroy in your life? Because if you have an idol in your life, you have not been given a new name. So the new name that we are talking about is the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. The name that is above every name. And Peter said in Acts chapter 3, verse 6, he says, I have no silver and gold. He says, silver and gold have I none, but what do I have is to give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. That name Jesus, the name that is above every name, that name I put it into every situation and every circumstance of my hearing. Where there is turbulence, there are so many countries all over the world where there is unrest. Father, I just plead that name, the name of Jesus. I plead it, Lord, that there will be peace. You see, while Peter said this, miracle happens. When you know the name of Jesus, when you call that name, miracle happens. When you stretch out your hand to heal, and signs and wonders are performed through the name of your holy servant Jesus. It's only that name, the name of Jesus, is the name that is above every name. And because he has been given a name, and before you can call that name, you need to know him. You need to walk with him. Because the Lord says, the prayer of the righteous, they are abomination unto the Lord. But when you call upon the Lord, he answers. When you call upon the Lord, he hears. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your husband and her husband. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his head. There's enmity between us and our Creator. But God paid the price on Calvary, and that's why he came in the form of man. And again, looking to Jesus, the founder and perfecter of our faith. There is none like you, O Lord. You are great, and your name is great in might. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. Jesus has invited, urged, and commanded us to pray in his name, and has promised incredible results. What is the purpose of the name of Jesus? The name of Jesus reminds us of the power, the presence, and the purpose of the risen Christ. It assures us that God's gracious intention is to save us. Our Lord Jesus brought God to humanity and now brings humans to God through the salvation he purchased. You remember these songs? All hail the power of Jesus' name. Let him just proceed for. When I call that name Jesus, 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 the name that is above every name is there for me. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. The power of praying in Jesus' name, not given by human beings, but by heaven. All other names that we have talked about are given by human beings. Everything that you need is that name, Jesus. For every name shall bow. John, Moses, Ruth, Boaz, Nehemiah, Jeremiah, name it, Ananias, Jezebel, Judas Iscariot, all died, and their names died with them. Among some of these names I've mentioned, there are some people that will never want to call their name Jezebel. You will not want to call your name Ananias or Judas Iscariot. But there are some names that remains, and when they die, that name died in the grave. But I want you to know, Jesus' name never dies. Over and over again, we read the name of Jesus. the devils are powerless because of his name. I say, I command you in the name of Jesus. I command you in the name of Jesus. Deliverance comes in the name of Jesus. I want to tell you testimony, because there are some of you that are living cowardice Christian life. Do you think I don't have time when I'm afraid? I do. Do you think I don't have time when I feel low? I do. But I want to tell you stories, testimonies that will encourage you in my Christian walk with the Lord. There was one time we went for evangelism in Nigeria. That was in 1980. What happened was that from nowhere, while we were in the house, a bird just came and was just all over the place, and the bird was about to either hit us or something. And with myself and the sister that we were witnessing, I stopped. I said, I command you in the name of Jesus, be destroyed. I command you in the name of Jesus, be destroyed. I said it the third time. Behold, the bird that was in the room just from the ceiling just fell down, and the bird died. I can tell you that is what is energizing me. I'm not just talking to you because I want to be on Facebook. I'm not just talking to you because I need a congregation. Neither do I need your tithes. What God has provided for us is more than sufficient. I'm talking to you because I know Jesus is the way. I'm talking to you because I know there's a name that has been given. That name, Jesus, is the name that is above every name. I'm talking to you, I'm preaching to you because I know that you also can experience what I've experienced, because I'm just an ordinary flesh. I'm talking to you because I know deliverance is yours. I'm talking to you because if you do not know this name, then there is a big problem. Because the name of Jesus is the name that is above every name. Healing occurred in his name. Salvation come up in his name. Everything we do and say is done in his name. Praying in Jesus' name is what brings us to victory. Jesus has invited, urged, and commanded us to pray in his name. We are admitting the bankruptcy of our own name. When I pray in Jesus' name, I come boldly before God because of the power of his name. There is power, there is power, there is power in the blood. Walking power, walking power, walking power in the blood. There is power. You see, the name of Jesus is synonymous. The blood that was shed, the blood of Jesus is what we are talking. The woman takes the name of her husband on all that entails. She no longer acts in her name, but in his. We identify with the person of Jesus. Jesus has literally given us his name. He said, when I use that name, I'm confessing that he is mine, that I am his. I'm confessing that whatever difficulty, whatever trouble I'm going through, that is able to deliver. We pray in his authority. We are like the child who picked up a policeman that wandered out into a busy intersection and began to direct traffic. The people in the cars followed the child's direction because they respected his position of authority. To pray in his name is to ask by his authority, and to ask by his authority is to ask in accordance to his will as revealed in his word. When you pray in his according to his will, he answers. We submit to his will. Jesus' authority rested with his submission to the Father. Because he said to the Father, thy will be done. Because himself and the Father, they are one. That is why prayers that ask for things contrary to the word of God will never be answered. I want to tell you, and I will repeat this. Prayers that ask things contrary to the word of God. You see, God has a place for you and I in heaven. This is not our home. This is not your resting place. There was a time when I was going to one Pentecostal church in Regina here. And what happened? We had to pray for that cherished woman of our congregation who was having uterine cancer. And we loved this woman. She was very great in the church. She was leading the church choir. She was such a fabulous woman. And as one of the elders, trusted elders in the congregation, we went there with my wife to pray for this woman. And everybody has been praying that God will heal her. God will touch her. God will do everything. I pray for God to heal. I pray for God to touch people. But as we were praying, I saw her body in a white robe. being carried to heaven. And I interrupted the prayer immediately, and I told her, I said, you are being taken into heaven. You are being taken to eternity. And this woman said, truly, Adeline Wilkins, that's the name of the woman. She said, truly, you are a prophet of God. I am going home. The Lord has revealed that to me. The following day, he went to be with the Lord in glory. What I want you to know is that if you pray according to his will, so we need to understand the will and purpose of God. Why prayers that ask for things contrary to the word of God will never be answered? When you ask for the life of your enemies to be killed, I'm not saying that your enemies cannot be killed by God. Look at what happened in the book of Esther. We read about that last week. Haman was destroyed. But when it is not God's will for that enemy of your soul to be destroyed, God is not going to do it. God may allow that enemy to be alive so that they can see the power, the salvation, the deliverance that is in that name, Jesus, if you remain steadfast in him. Because I remember when we went to Nigeria to build a hospital, that was in 2007. Somebody came to meet us from the estate in Ibadan. They said, if you want to complete this project, you need to come and be a member of our secret court. And I look at him, I say, listen, the power that is in me, myself and my wife, you say is greater than the power that is in secret court. Then the man threatened us. He said, look at so many uncompleted buildings in this estate, Ulubana estate. He said, yours will be like that. You will not complete it. I said, you are a liar. Get thee out of here. I want you to know that when you know your God, what you do, you say, Lord, destroy that man. Lord, destroy him. No, we pray for him. And what happened, it took us 3 years because it's a big hospital and we had to be stopping the project on and off because of the corruption. Human hearts, human beings are corrupt. Just as you have corruption in the Western world, the corruption in the third world country is also endemic. And so this guy came to meet us after we've completed the hospital. He said, truly, you are children of the living God. I want you to know the testimony, the power, because we are attacked. The Bible says, Christians seek not yet repose. You are in the midst of foes. Watch and pray. The only way that you can overcome all the attackers, all the enemies of soul, your soul, is through that name, Jesus. That's why he has been given a new name, a name that is above every name. And at the name of Jesus, every knee must bow and every tongue must confess that Jesus is Lord. The last thing I want to talk to you is about praying expectantly. When we pray in Jesus' name, we may expect the answer in accord with the value of his name. So we can pray with great and excited expectation. You see, when I go to the Lord, when I call upon the Father, I say, Lord, I'm trusting you. I close my eyes if it is possible. When I'm driving, when I'm praying, you know that you cannot close your eyes when you are driving. Otherwise, you find yourself in the ditch. So, I imagine within my mind that this is going to happen. This is going to happen. And you have to pray with mind of expectation. That's what is written in Hebrews 11. Faith is the evidence of things not seen, the substance of things hoped for. And that name, Jesus, is the name that is above every name. So, Lord, I thank you, Lord, for your message this morning. Because you have been given a new name. Lord, those who are listening to me, who have not received that new name, who have not received you as Lord and Savior, Lord, come into their lives, Lord. Lord, as you translated my life, as you have ministered unto us, Lord, as a family, Lord, and that, Lord, you will translate their lives and minister unto them, Lord, because you are the resurrection and the life. For 47 years, I can say years of the truth, you remain a faithful Father. So, Lord, I just pray, Lord, that you will just remain a faithful Father to those that are listening, to those that are falling away, Lord, Father, restore them, because you are the restorer. To children that have walked away from their faith, the faith of Abraham, Isaac, the faith of their father, Lord, our father in faith, Lord, Father, restore them. Let your restoration, Lord, and to those that are backsliding, to those that are living immoral lives, Lord. Father, we just pray that you set them free, you deliver them, and let your grace, let your anointing be upon them, Lord. Father, we just honor you. We thank you, Lord, for this beautiful day. Thank you, Lord, for you have made the day, and then we will rejoice and give you the glory. Father, be ye exalted, because you have been given a new name. The name of Jesus, the name that is above every name, and every name was bow. Every difficulty in the lives of my hearers this morning, I decree that they bow. Every difficulties in my own life, my wife's life, my children, my grandchildren, Lord, I decree that they bow, so that, Lord, your name will be exalted. Your name will be glorified. Father, we honor you. We give you the glory, for we have prayed in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Amen.